What's going on, everybody? Hopefully everybody's body is feeling good after Monday and Tuesday workout with Coach Kendal. So today's workout is going to be very similar to what we did Monday, just a couple brand new exercises within the workouts. So remember, with the 12 exercises we're doing, we're breaking them up into four separate circuits. So the first three we're going to do in a circuit three times, and the second group of three times, and so on and so forth. So sit tight, enjoy this workout. Here's our incline push-ups. Remember, feet going to be on top of the chair. As we're doing this, keep your hips as high as possible. You want to keep your hips up as you're bending your elbows, pushing through the ground, and doing as many repetitions as possible. Here we got our tricep dips. Same rules apply. Make sure your legs remain straight out, toes up. You want to keep your elbows in. You don't want to have your elbows flare out too much. Keep your knuckles facing forward. All right, this is a new movement. This is called your seated shoulder in press. So what's going to happen? You're going to press up like it's a regular shoulder press. After you get down to the bottom when you're at 90 degrees, you're going to rotate forward at the shoulder joint, keeping them elbows at 90 degrees before you go right back to the vertical position and press up. This is going to work all the shoulder muscles you have in your body, including your rear delts and strengthening your rotator cuff. A ground chest press. Remember, elbows going to be down to the ground, legs are going to be up, knees are going to be bent at 90 degrees, cross at the ankles, and then we're going to press all the way up. Our kneeing front and side raises. This is very crucial. Remember, we're doing this on our knees to activate our core. So as you're doing this exercise, try to remain still throughout the whole entire exercise. The only thing that's going to be moving is your arms, nothing more, nothing less. You're really going to feel in your lower back. You're really going to feel in your hamstrings if you really focus and do this the right way. New movement. These are your three-level arm curls. So what's going to happen is you're going to stagger your feet, put your chest on top of the chair. Then you're going to grab the weight before you start curling. This is three levels because you're going to curl this three different times before you get the repetition of one. So as you're curling this, you're making the three different angles with your arms. So the first time you curl it up, you're going to make it a 90-degree angle. Curl back up. Then you're going to make a 135-degree angle. Curl back up. Then you're going to make a 180-degree angle before you curl right back up. This is really going to burn you out. It's give you a different movement, different exercise with your arms so you really feel it in your bicep muscles. New movement. These are your bent over rows. Now you're going to be bent over the same way as you was when you was doing bent over raises, but now you're going to roll it to your chest. All right, so make sure your arms go locked out, bring it to your chest, squeeze it, then go right back to the starting position. Your wide push-ups. Remember, your arms are going to be really wide, hands a little bit outside your elbows. You're going to push through the ground, and everything comes up in one unit. If this is still a little bit of a struggle for you, back to the Monday video, you can revert to that modified push-up we talked about. New movement. These are called Supermans. As you rise up, your head comes up, arms comes up, legs come up. Only thing that stays on the ground is your stomach and your waist. Now, I got two food cans in each hand for weight resistance because this will be a difficult exercise. So as you raise up, you're going to hold this position for 5 seconds. Slowly exhale before you go back down to the starting position. Make sure you hold that position to challenge yourself before you go right back down to the starting position. Last but not least, now we have our ab movements. It's going to be the same movements that we did on Monday. Going to finish it out strong. We got our Russian twists. We got our sit-up and press. Last but not least, then we're going to have our leg raises.